Now, at 10, bad times mean sometimes hardworking people can't get a raise. But should the boss? This one did for 2 years.
We have some questions for you. Can you tell us why you and your deputy director are the only ones who received
the question tonight? Will she answer as she drives off in her luxury car? Good evening. She is not the only person who has to answer tough questions. I'm Sylvia Weatherspoon.
And I'm Michael Marsh. Her second in command does too. Since they both got raises, everyone else, nothing. This is at the Capital Area Human Services District in Baton Rouge. That agency budget is more than $2 million less than it was last year. The News 2 Investigative Unit, Chief Investigator Chris Nakamoto, follows the money and finds out why those two got raises and no one else did.
The Capital Area Human Services District provides social and other behavioral health services for 7 parishes in our area. Tonight, questions remain over why the organization's top two in command were the only ones who received raises.
Tucked away on Government Street, this state building houses 200-plus employees who work for the Capital Area Human Services District. It's an organization led by Executive Director Jan Kosofsky and Deputy Director Carol Nacost. Over the past 2 years, Kosofsky said her organization couldn't pay for raises for her 200 employees. It's detailed in this letter she sent to the state 2 years in a row. The letter requests the approval to implement a layoff avoidance measure of withholding performance adjustments, which are also known as raises, for all employees statewide. But salary documents the News 2 Investigative Unit obtained show Director Kosofsky and Deputy Director Nacost accepted fat raises during the time the organization was cash strapped.
You should not accept a merit increase just on an ethical standpoint, a moral compass. It's just something wrong with that. There's something terribly wrong with accepting a merit increase when you have 200 plus employees who have not had a merit increase in years.
We've disguised the identity of this employee at their request out of fear of retaliation.
If you speak with them, then you will be targeted. If you complain, you're targeted.
While employees' salaries have stayed the same over the past few years, their bosses' salaries continue to balloon. In 2011, Executive Director Jan Kosofsky earned $168,646. Now she makes $189,467. That's a raise of about $21,000.
During this time, Jan Kosofsky issued a pay raise to just one employee, the second in command of her agency.
In 2011, Deputy Director Carol Nacost earned $126,422. Now she makes $142,043. That's more than a $15,000 raise. News 2 requested a sit-down interview with Kosofsky about this issue. She said no.
Can you tell us why you and your deputy director are the only ones who received raises at
you
Capital Area?
You can talk to my board. The process is that they would be the ones that would make that decision.
Even though you submitted a letter saying the agency had no money?
Excuse me.
When News 2 started calling board members who were appointed by the governor, one of them told me he wasn't aware the agency withheld raises from employees at the time the board approved Kosofsky's raise. He and several other board members then referred all questions to board president Vicki King.
News 2 also requested a sit-down interview with Ms. King about the raises. We were told through the agency's public relations firm, King declined. So we caught up with King as she left work to give her an opportunity to explain the board's decision.
Was the board aware that she had submitted letters to the state saying that the agency had no money for raises?
Sir, again, I have given you a statement, so you may use whatever statement was provided to you.
But that statement didn't answer any of our questions.
And we also suggested if you wanted to have other, if you wanted other answers, that you could send us any questions you had in writing. So thank you.
As the board avoided our questions, so did Kosofsky. It sheds light into why some employees believe more oversight needs to be brought to an organization that spends your tax money.
While board president Vicki King declined an on-camera interview, she did send out this letter to employees 2 days ago, saying the board is proud of its decision to give Kosofsky $21,000 in raises over the last 2 years. She then blamed the legislature for not providing money for employee raises.
Chris Nakamoto, WBRZ Balance News.
17 board members who govern the Capital Area Human Services District are unpaid. They serve 3-year terms.